live in succession, in division, in parts, in particles.
Meanwhile, within man is the soul of the whole,
the wise silence, the universal beauty,
to which every part and particle is equally related,
the eternal one.
And this deep power in which we exist,
and whose beatitude is all accessible to us,
is not only self-sufficing and perfect in every hour,
but the act of seeing,
and the thing seen,
the seer and the spectacle,
the subject and the object are one.
We see the world piece by piece,
as the sun,
the moon,
the animal,
the tree,
but the whole, of which these are the shining parts,
is the soul.
I'm sitting here wanting memories to teach me to see the beauty in the world through my own eyes. I am sitting here wanting memories to teach me to see the beauty in the world through my own eyes. You used to rock me in the grave. You said you'd hold me till the pains of life were gone. You said you'd comfort me in times like these, and now I need you, now I need you. And you are gone. I am sitting here wanting memories to teach me to see the beauty in the world through my own eyes. Since you've gone and left me, there's been so little beauty, but I know I saw it clearly through your eyes. Now the world outside is such a cold and bitter place. Here inside I have your thing that will console. And when I try to hear your voice above the storms of life, then I remember all the things that I was told. I am sitting here wanting memories to teach me to see the beauty in the world through my own eyes. I am sitting here memories to teach me to see the beauty in the world through my own
eyes. You know what I'd like to be? You know what I'd like to be? If I had my goddamn choice.
What? Stop swearing.
Ow. You know that song, If a Body Catch a Body Coming Through the Rye?
If a body meet a body, it's a poem by Robert Burns.
I know it's a poem by Robert Burns. I thought it was If a Body Catch a Body. You see, I keep picturing all these kids playing some game in this big field of Ryan Hall. Thousands of little kids, and nobody's around. Well, nobody big. I mean, except me. And I'm standing on the edge of some crazy cliff. What I have to do, I have to catch everybody if they start to go over the cliff. I mean, if they're running, and they don't know where they're going, I have to come out from somewhere and catch them. That's all I do. All day. I'd just be the catcher in the Ryan ball. I know, it's crazy, but that's all I really want to be.
Once, when I was 6 years old, I saw a magnificent painting in a picture book called True Stories About the Jungle.
It was a picture of a boa constrictor in the act of swallowing a savage beast. I attempted to recreate that picture. Unfortunately, it looked like a hat.
So that's why at the age of six, I gave up what might have been a magnificent career as a painter.
And I chose another profession, an and I learned to pilot airplanes. I have flown a little over all parts of the world.
I have had a great many encounters with a great many people who have all been concerned with matters of consequence. I have lived a great deal among grown-ups. I have seen them intimately, close at hand, and that hasn't much improved my opinion of them.
Whenever I met one of them who seemed to me at all clear-sighted, I would try the experiment of showing him my drawing of the boa constrictor eating an elephant. I would attempt to discover if this was a person of true understanding.
So I stopped talking to grown-ups about boa constrictors.
Or jungles.
Or stars.
I would sink to his level. I would talk to him about golf, and bridge, and politics, and neckties.
And they would be so impressed with me.
So he lived his life alone, without anyone he could really talk to.
Until he had an accident with his plane in the desert of the Sahara.
6 years ago.
Gone to sleep.
What is that object?
That is not an object. It flies. It's an airplane.
It's my airplane.
What?
Have you dropped down from the sky?
Yes.
Oh! Oh, that's very exciting!
Oh, you two come from the sky. Which is your planet?
Do you come from another planet?
It is true that on that airplane, you can't have come from very far away.
Oh, where do you come from?
Where do you live?
Where do you want to take your sheep?
The thing that is so good about the box you have given me is that at night he can use it as his house.
Yes, that's true. And I can even give you a post to tie him to, and some string to tie him with.
Tie him? Why would you tie him?
Well, if you don't tie him, he could wander off somewhere and get lost.
Where do you think he would go?
Anywhere.
Straight ahead of him.
That doesn't matter. Where I live, everything is so small. Straight ahead of him, nobody can go very far.
All we do, our whole lives, is go from one little piece of holy ground to the next.
Dream.
flowers that have thorns.
Yes, even flowers that have thorns.
Then the thorns, what use are they?
The thorns are of no use at all. Flowers have thorns just for spite.
Oh. I don't believe you. Flowers, they aren't weak creatures. They are naive. They reassure themselves as best they can. They believe their thorns are terrible weapons. And you actually believe that the...
No! I don't believe anything.
I don't believe anything! I answered you with the first thing that came into my head! Can't you see that I am very busy with matters of consequence?
Matters of consequence! You talk just like the others.
You mix everything up!
You confuse everything.
I know a planet where there is a certain red-faced gentleman. He has never smelled a flower.
He has never looked at a star.
He has never loved anyone.
He has never done anything his whole life but add up figures.
And all day he says over and over, just like you, I am busy with matters of consequence.
And that makes him swell up with pride.
But he is not a man. He is a mushroom.
A what?
A mushroom! The flowers have been growing thorns for millions of years. The sheep have been eating them just the same. And is it not a matter of consequence to try to understand why the flower goes through so much trouble to grow thorns which are never of any use to them? Is the warfare between the sheep and the flowers not important?
Is this not a more consequence than if that red-faced gentleman sells? And if I myself know a flower which is unique in all the world, which grows nowhere but on my head, but which one sheep could destroy in a single bite in the morning without even realizing what he is doing. You think that is not important? If someone loves a flower...
If someone loves a flower...
which just one single blossom grows in all the millions and millions of stars, it is enough to make him happy to look at the stars. He can say to himself, somewhere my flower is there.
Somewhere my flower is there.
But if the sheep eats the flower, in one moment all the stars will be darkened. And you think that is not important?
Your flower that you love is not in danger.
I will draw you a muzzle for your sheep.
I will draw you a rail so you can put around your flower.
I will!
It is such a secret place! The land of tears.
Yes, she was
coquettish creature,
and her mysterious adornment lasted for days.
to scream for me.
A fear of drafts. That is bad luck for a plant.
This flower is a very complex creature.
At night, won't you put me under a glass globe?
It is very cold where you live.
In the place where I come from.
I was just going to look for it when you spoke to me.
So you have me with your thorn. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
I have been silly. I ask for forgiveness.
Try to be happy. Of course I love you.
Of course. I love you. It is my fault that you have not known it all the while.
That is of no importance.
But you have been as foolish as I.
Let the glass flow deep. I don't mind anymore.
But the wind.
My cold is not as bad as all that. Cool night air will do me good. I am a flower.
But the animals.
Well, I must endure the presence of two or three caterpillars.
If I wish to be acquainted with the butterflies.
Seems that they are very beautiful.
And if not the butterflies we have in this, who will call them on? You will be very far away.
As for the large animals,
I am not at all afraid of any of them. I have my claws.
This moment to rise.
she recognize me when she had never seen me before?
Approach! So that it may see you better.
It is contrary to etiquette to yawn in the presence of a queen. I forbid you to do so.
I can't stop it. I can't help myself. I've come on a long journey and I've had no sleep.
Oh, then I order you to yawn. It is years since I've seen anyone yawning. Yawns to me are an object of curiosity. Come now, yawn again. It is an honor.
That frightens me.
Hum-hum. That I would eat sometimes to yawn and sometimes to... If I order the general to change himself in the seabed, and if the general did not carry out the order which he had received, it would not be the fault of the general. It would be my fault.
May I sit down?
I order you to do so!
Your Majesty, I beg that you will excuse my asking you a question.
I order you to ask me a question!
Your Majesty, over what do you rule?
Over everything.
Over everything?
Over all that?
Over all that.
And the stars obey you?
Certainly they do. They obey instantly. I do not permit insubordination.
Well, then I should like to see a sunset. Do me that kindness. Order the sun to set.
If I order the general to fly from one flower to another like a butterfly, or try to tragic drama, or to change himself in the seabed, and if the general did not carry out the order which he had received, who would be wrong? The general or myself?
You.
Exactly. One must require from each one the duty which each one can perform. Accepted authority rests first of all on reason. If you ordered your people to go and throw themselves into the sea, it would raise up a revolution. I have the right to require obedience because my orders are reasonable.
Then my sunset?
You shall have your sunset. I shall command it, but according to my assignment of government, we shall have to wait until conditions are favorable.
Oh, when will that be?
Hum-hum. That'll be about... That will be this evening at about 20 minutes to 8, and you will see how well I am obeyed.
I have nothing more to do here, and now I think I will be on my way.
Do not go! Do not go! I'll make you a minister!
Minister of what?
Of justice!
There is nothing to judge.
We do not yet know that. I have not made full tour of my kingdom. There is no room here for a carriage, and I am very old. It tires me to walk.
Oh, but I have looked already.
Then you shall judge yourself. That is the most difficult thing of all. It is much more difficult to judge oneself than to judge others. If you succeed in judging yourself rightly, then you are indeed a man of true wisdom.
Yes, but I can judge myself anywhere. I do not need to live on this planet.
Hum-hum. I have good reason to believe that on my planet there is no rat. I hear him at night. You will judge this rat, and from time to time you will condemn him to death. Thus his life will depend on your justice. But you will pardon him on each occasion. He must be treated thriftily, you know. He's the only one we have.
I do not like to condemn anyone to death. And now I think I will be on my way.
No!
If your Majesty wishes to be properly obeyed, she should be able to give a reasonable order. She should be able to, for example, order me to be gone by the end of 1 minute. Seems to me conditions are favorable.
I'll make you my ambassador.
I'm about to receive a visit from an admirer.
Good morning! That is a queer hat you are wearing!
This is a hat for salutes. It is to raise and salute when people acclaim me. Unfortunately, nobody ever passes this way.
Yes?
Clap your hands, one against the other.
This is more entertaining than the visit with the queen. And what does one do to make the hat come down?
Do you really admire me very much?
What does that mean? Admire.
Admire means that you regard me as the handsomest, the best dressed, the richest, and the most intelligent man on this planet.
But you are the only man on this planet.
Do me this favor. Admire me just the same.
I admire you. But what if there are not to interest you so much?
If you come up with an idea before anybody else does, You take a patent out of it. It is yours. And so with the stars, they belong to me. Because no one else before me ever thought of owning them.
Yes, that is true. But if I own a silk scarf, I could wrap that scarf around my neck and take it away with me. If I owned a flower, I could pluck that flower and take it away with me. But you cannot pluck the stars from heaven.
No, but I can put them in the bank.
What's that mean?
It means I write the number of my stars on a little piece of paper. Then I put this piece of paper in a drawer and I lock it with a key.
And that is all?
That isn't it.
It is poetic. It is rather entertaining. But it is of no great consequence. I myself own a flower which I water every day. And I also own 3 volcanoes which I clean out each week. Or also clean out the one that is extinct. One never knows. It is of some use to my volcanoes. And it is of some use to my flowers that I own them. But you are of no use to the stars.
Sunsets every day. Come together. come.
What are you doing? What is that big book?
I am a geographer.
What is a geographer?
A geographer is a scholar who knows the locations of all the rivers, seas, mountains, towns, and deserts.
That is very interesting. Here at last is a man with a real profession. Oh, your planet is very beautiful. Has it any oceans?
I couldn't tell.
Oh. Has it any mountains?
I couldn't tell.
And towns and rivers and deserts?
I couldn't tell you that.
But you are a geographer.
Exactly. But I am not an explorer. I haven't a single explorer on the entire planet. It is not the geographer's job to go out and count the rivers, the seas, the mountains, the towns and the deserts. The geographer is much too important to go loafing about. He does not leave his desk, but he receives explorers in his study. He asks them questions and he notes down what they recall of their travels. And if the recollections of anyone among them seem interesting, an inquiry is ordered into the explorer's moral character.
Why is that?
Because an explorer who told lies would bring disaster to the books of the geographer. So an explorer who drank too much.
Why is that?
Because intoxicated men see double. Then the geographer would note down two mountains in the place where there was only one.
I think I know someone who would make a very poor explorer.
That is quite possible. Then when the moral character of the explorer is shown to be good, an inquiry is ordered into his discovery.
Oh, one goes to see it.
No, that would be too complicated. But one requires the explorer to furnish proofs. If the discovery inquiry is that of a large mountain, one requires the explorer to bring back large stones. But you come from far away. You are an explorer. You shall describe your planet to me.
Huh. Where I live, it is not very interesting. It is also small. I have three volcanoes, two of which are active and the other is extinct, but one never knows.
One never knows.
I also have a flower.
We do not record flowers.
Why not? The flower is the most beautiful thing on my planet.
We do not record them because they are ephemeral.
What does that mean? Ephemeral?
Geographies are books which, of all books, are most concerned with matters of consequence. They never become old-fashioned. It is very rarely that a mountain moves from one place to the other. It is very rarely that an ocean empties itself of its waters. We write on eternity.
But an extinct volcano may come alive again.
Whether the volcano is extinct or alive, the thing that matters most to us is the mountain. It does not change.
What does that mean? Ephemeral.
It means which is in danger of speedy disappearance.
Huh. Is my flower ephemeral?
It certainly is.
My flower is ephemeral. And he has only four thorns to protect himself against all the world. And I have left him on my planet all alone. What planet would you advise me to visit next?
The planet Earth. It has a good reputation.
Stars.
veil of gold, the color of the moonlight, flashed across the sand.
Which I have come down.
This is the earth.
Oh, then there are no men on the earth?
This is the desert. There are no men in the desert.
The earth is large.
I wonder if the stars are set alight in heaven, so that one day each of us may find his own again. Look at my planet.
It is right there above us. How far away it is.
It is beautiful.
What has brought you?
I've been having some trouble
with a flower. Ah! Where are the men?
It is a little lonely in the desert.
It is all so lonely among men. You are a funny animal.
You are no thicker than a finger.
You cannot even travel very far.
But I am more powerful than a finger of a king. I can carry you farther than any ship could take you.
Whomever I touch, I send back to earth from whence he came.
You are pure and innocent, and you come from a star.
You come from a star.
You move me to pity. You are so weak on this earth made of granite.
I can help you. Someday, if you grow too lonely for your planet.
I can.
Oh, I understand you very well. But why do you always speak in riddles?
Need each other. To you, I should be unique in all the world.
understand.
There is a flower. I think that she has tamed me.
It is possible. On Earth, one sees all sorts of things.
Oh, but this is not on the Earth.
On another planet?
Yes.
Are there hunters on that planet?
No.
Ah, that is interesting. Are there chickens?
No.
Nothing is perfect. My life is very monotonous. I hunt chickens, and men hunt me. All the chickens are just alike, and all the men are just alike. And in consequence, I'm a little bored. But if you tame me, it will be as if the sun had come to shine on my life. I would know the sound of a step that would be different from all other steps. Others send me hurrying back underneath the ground. The doors. It would calm me like music. And look. You see the night sky above you? You have hair that is the color of that sky. Think how wonderful that would be if you tamed me. The night sky, which is also black, would bring me back the thought of you. And I would love to listen to the wind underneath the starless sky.
I want to. Very much.
But I have not much time. I have problems to discover.
And a great many things to understand.
One only understands the things that one tames. Men, they have no time to understand anything. They buy things already made at shops. But there is no shop anywhere where one can buy friendship. And so men, they have no friends. If you want a friend, tame me.
What must I do to tame you?
You must be very patient. First, you sit at a little distance from me, like that, the grass. And I shall look at you at the corner of my eye. And you will say nothing. Words are the source of misunderstanding. But each day, you will sit a little closer. One must observe the proper rites.
What is a rite?
These are also actions too often blended. They are what makes one day different from other days. One hour from another hour. There is a rite, for instance, among my hunters. Every Thursday, they go and dance with the village girl. So Thursday is a wonderful day. I can take a walk just as far as the vineyard. But if the hunters danced on just any day, every day would be like every other day, and I should have no vacation at all. And then come back and say goodbye to me. And I will make you the present
of a secret.
Responsible for my rose.
You become responsible for
forever for what you have attained.
Thank you.
what makes the desert beautiful is that somewhere hides a well.
When I was a little boy, I lived in an old house, and legend told us that there was a treasure buried there. To be sure, no one had ever known how to find it. Perhaps no one had ever even looked. But it cast an enchantment over that house. My home was hiding a secret in the depths of its heart.
Yes, the house, the stars, the desert, what gives them their beauty is something that is invisible.
I'm glad.
You agree with my thoughts?
Sitting here, no, the breeze too.
Go from one
My star that can be found right above the place where I came to the earth. A year ago.
I feel as though I'm about to be born.
Tell me that this is all only a bad dream.
Disappear the snake in the meeting place and the star?
Sacred day.
The thing that is important is the thing that is not seen.
The thing that is important is the thing that is not seen. Yes, I know.
It is just as it was with the one.
Because of the pulley and the rope, what you gave me to drink was like music. You remember how good it was.
Yes, I know.
There is only movement.
And change.
And at night, you will look to the stars.
Where I live, everything is so small. I can't show you where my star is to be found.
It is better like that.
My star will be just one of the stars for you.
And so you will love to watch all the stars in the heavens.
They will be your friends. And besides, I will make you a present.
I love to hear your laughter.
That is my present, just that. It will be as it was when we drank the water.
What are you trying to say?
All men have the stars. They are not the same things for different people. For some who are travelers, the stars are guides. For others, they are no more than little lights in the sky. For others who are scholars, they are prophets. For my businessmen, they were wealth. But all these stars are silent. You alone, you have these stars as no one else has them.
I don't understand.
In one of the stars I shall be living. In one of them I shall be laughing. And so it will be as if all the stars were laughing when you look up at the sky at night. You, only you, are the stars that can laugh. And when your sorrow is comforted,
time soothes all sorrows.
You will be content that you have known me. You will always be my friend. You will want to laugh with me, and you will sometimes open your window so for that pleasure. And your friends will be properly astonished to see you laughing as you look up at the sky. And you will say, yes, the stars always make me laugh. And they will think you are crazy. It will have been my trick that I shall have played on you.
It will be as if, in place of all the stars, I've given you a great number of little bells that knew how to laugh. Tonight, you know.
Do not come.
I shall not leave you.
Nothing in the universe has contact.
There is only movement and change.
Sacred day.
I shall look as if I were suffering.
I shall look as if I were dying. It is like that.
Do not come to see that. It is not worth the trouble.
I shall not leave you.
I tell you, it is also because of the snake.
She must not bite you.
Snakes. They are malicious creatures.
Just one might bite you just for fun.
I shall not leave you.
Responsible for her. But she's so weak. She's so naive. She 'Tis four thorns of no use at all to protect herself against all the world.
And then the little bells are changed into tears.
I keep picturing all these kids playing some game in this big field of riot doll.
Thousands of little kids, and nobody's around.
Nobody paid, I mean.
I mean except me.
And I'm standing on the edge of some crazy cliff.
What I have to do?
I have to catch everybody if they start to go over the cliff. I mean, if they're running, and they don't look where they're going.
And I have to come out of somewhere and catch them.
That's all I do, all day.
I'd just be the catcher in the riot doll.
I know it's crazy, but it's the only thing I really want to be.